opened in 1967. They've hosted the tournament for the last 10 years. It's next on CSTV. That's the pot of gold at the end of the rainbow in Division III basketball. Today, Rochester races with Wisconsin Stevens Point for the right to be number one. 394 teams started the 2005 Division III season with one ultimate goal, hoisting the NCAA championship trophy. Two squads remain, each hoping to lay claim to their title-winning glory. The Division III men's championship game is next on CSTV. Hoops fans can hardly wait for this one. The team play, the heart, and the hustle, all that is Division III athletics. Salem, Virginia has got it all today. CSTV presents the Division III men's basketball championship game. Top-ranked Wisconsin Stevens Point taking on the challengers from Rochester, New York. A very pleasant welcome to you. I'm Joe Beninati. At the Division III level, the colleges and the universities are always on the lookout for the overall quality of the educational experience. And in this year's tournament, we've learned an awful lot about these student athletes and their character. The field of 48 has been whittled down to two. Wisconsin Stevens Point, just too long and too strong in outlasting York, while Rochester went down to the final seconds to beat Calvin. A 15-year Division I head coach, Eddie Fogler, joins me today. Eddie, what is it about the Division III tournament that excites you most?
Well, Joe, this is my third year being here for this championship game, and I'm honored and excited to be here once again. Two key elements are always important with championship basketball. Superb coaching. We have two veterans who are as good as it gets. Talented players, we have that also, and they will be performing at the highest level. And at the end of the day, one of these two lucky teams will be cutting down the nets, Joe, and adding memories that they will cherish for a lifetime.
Well, Rochester sure made the most of the moment last night, and Yellow Jackets radio play-by-play man JC DeLass had the best seat in the house for the game-winning call.
Looking low, throw it to the left side. McAllister up for three. Good! With 4.7 seconds remaining. McAllister for three. Here comes Calvin. They quick dribble drive. Briesman. He lost it. The ball's on the floor. That's the end of the game. The University of Rochester has won.
Well, Gabe Perez makes the key pass across court for the winning basket. The 5'11 burly point guard is going to have to lead his team if Rochester is going to win here today against the very inexperienced freshman point guards of Wisconsin Stevens Point.
On the other side of the equation, it was Wisconsin Stevens Point looking every ounce the champion an evening ago. And their top player brings his best in all of the big games.
Well, he is outstanding. Jason Calso, Joe, a power forward who leads his team in scoring and rebounding. There are other players in his position who can do that, but how many other players also lead his team in block shots and an assist? And Joe, he's also second on his team in steals. When I look at Division III basketball, I believe Jason Calso is the best all-around player in Division III.
All the nerve endings have to be tingling for him now. These students from Wisconsin making a long journey, spending many dollars to see who will be number one. You find out with us on CSTV.
It's true. The owners of 40 million different cars in America all have one thing in common.
Two red-hot basketball teams. Rochester's won 15 of its last 16. Wisconsin Stevens Point has won its last 10 in the NCAA tournament. Something's got to give today. You know, when we're playing college basketball, the player who knows his teammates best is usually the point guard. So why don't we have the point guards do the introductions of the lineups and start first on the Rochester side.
Hi, I'm Gabe Perez from the University of Rochester Yellow Jackets, and this is today's starting lineup. From Corpus Christi, Texas, number 31, Gabe Perez. From Pittsburgh, Pennsylvania, number 24, Brendan McAllister. From Albany, New York, number 30, Jeff Duran. From Corning, New York, number 42, Jonathan Onyeruka. And from Waltham, Massachusetts, number 21, Seth Halvin.
And those five work under the direction of longtime head coach Mike Neer, the all-time winningest coach in the history of Yellow Jackets basketball. They go up against Wisconsin Stevens Point, and the Pointers would dearly love to have their starting point guard in the lineup. But you'll see a young man who will introduce his teammates who won't be able to go today.
My name is Tamara Schroeferd, senior point guard from the University of Wisconsin-Stevens Point for today's starting lineup for championship game. At point guard, number 24, Steve Hicklin. At shooting guard, number 33, Nick Bennett. At small forward, number 34, John Kroll. At power forward, number 44, Jason Kelso. And the big man in the middle, number 50, Eric Moss.
And the man who leads the pointers into this championship game for the second consecutive season, ninth year as the head coach, Jack Bennett, 55-year-old Pittsburgh, Pennsylvania native. And Eddie Fogler, you know that man well. You know that coaching family extremely well. And this is the point in the day, the point in the season where coaches just love to rise for a challenge.
Well, this is what it's all about, Joe. Both these coaches have done terrific jobs with their respective basketball teams. Both have been in coaching a long time. Both have the experience necessary to lead their team to this championship victory.
As these two teams hit the floor, you got a quick peek at last night's hero, Brendan McAllister, the senior from Pittsburgh for Rochester, an outside shooting threat. The fans inside Salem Civic Center have been howling their lungs out since lunchtime. And we are ready for the Division III National Championship game. Rochester in the traveling blue, Wisconsin Stevens Point, top ranked and defending champs in gold. They want to go inside to Seth Hauben, and that was the first order of business on the pointers' defensive legend today.
Well, Hauben is their leading scorer. He is their only inside presence for the for Rochester to have a chance here today. Halpin's going to have to put up some big numbers.
Quick move to the inside. That won't fall for John Kroll. Kroll, since he's been in the starting lineup, this team is 40-3.
Joe, right away we see the freshman Hicklin on the senior Perez, a key matchup in this basketball game.
Geron's three won't fall, and the floor rebound belongs to the aforementioned Kroll. It'll be Steve Hicklin to walk it back ahead. This is a redshirt freshman, Eddie, and he's someone that we need to pay special attention to today.
Absolutely. A young man who sat out last year, but he's got a lot of experience, although he did not play in any of the basketball games.
Jason Calso for three. That rims out, ricochets to the sideline. Geron will watch it go, and this goes back over to the Yellow Jackets. We're still looking for the first points in this, the second minute of the first half.
Well, the pointers are a multiple defensive basketball team. They have started off in straight man-to-man, but I expect them to play a lot of zone as this game moves forward.
I know you really like the 3-2 zone they put on York last night, York College of Pennsylvania.
Well, they're so tall and so long, Joe, it's very difficult to get open looks first. They're very active zone defenses.
Onyeruka, the freshman forward. Gabe Perez wearing that sleeve on his left leg. He bruised his shin just before the Sweet 16. He was fouled on the outside. It's Nick Bennett's first personal. Nick Bennett, what a hero for the pointers last year. He was the most outstanding player in the NCAA Division III tournament.
And here are the pointers in their 3-2 zone against the out-of-bounds underneath play by Rochester.
Perez will take it for three. Kind of point guard who looks to distribute. He doesn't often want his own shot.
Well, Perez, one weakness of Perez is the range of his jump shot. He's not a particularly good three-point shooter. I would expect the pointers to back off and try to contain his dribble penetration. It's
been a steady diet of John Kroll. Will that basket count? It could have been goaltending. As Kroll got a defender on his hip. Foul is on Gabe Perez. It's his first.
Right away, we see the pointers going inside and the quick reverse of Kroll, and he gets the angle to the basket, and now a chance for a three-point play.
Here's a great free throw shooter, Eddie. Before sectional play began, he hit 26 of his last 27.
Well, the whole team, Joe, they're seventh in the nation at 76.5% from the free throw line. Incredible statistic.
And they'll extend the defense a little bit.
They'll love to press on made free throws, generally back to the zone.
Geron for three.
Well, if Rochester's going to have any chance here today, they must bang home the three. Very big shot by the freshman, Jeff Geron, shooting 35% from beyond the arc.
Got to make him feel good, Eddie. He was 0-for-3 last night in Rochester's win over Calvin.
Well, pressing's one issue, but when you press, you have to get back in transition. The inside-out look by Rochester and the open three for Geron. Nice play.
This will go back over to the Yellow Jackets of the University of Rochester. Early going in the men's Division III National Championship game. Joe Beninati, Eddie Fogler, so glad you've tuned in on CSTV. Mike Neer against Jack Bennett in the coaching box for these two teams.
Pointers back man-to-man. Eric Moss with the key matchup on Halbin, trying to use his size to make it difficult for Halbin to score inside.
Moss,
the Yellow Jackets,
a very good defender, was a factor last night with 12 points and 12 boards. Mike Neer told us the Yellow Jackets aren't afraid to play a half-court set, especially when this guy's at the control. Perez finding Giron. Shot clock at two, and then McAllister traveled.
Great defensive possession by Wisconsin Stevens Point. They guarded the ball extremely well. Rochester could not dribble penetrate at all in that possession.
Pointers fans have so many things to cheer about. The early turnover story. This is a Wisconsin Stevens Point team into play today, 28-3. They wear the gold. Calso into the lane. That soft touch didn't befriend him there. Perez squeaking away with a rebound. Perez lob inside on Urruca. And the follow for Halbin, an academic All-America, and he wouldn't get it to stay put.
Well, the value of size. Halbin not used to playing against such a tall basketball team as the Pointers.
Hicklin with a runner.
Well, there's a young man that was playing only 6 minutes a game until the injury, and now is playing over 25 minutes a game after Relford went down with a hand problem.
Tomaris Relford, a broken hand in this tournament. Sean Lee missed a boatload of time earlier in the year, the backup point guard. So they go to last year's redshirt, Steve Hicklin. Anya Ruka using the rim well there to protect himself.
But how about the pass, Joe, from Halpin? The Pointers double down at the low post. They're trying to limit the attempts of Halpin, and he finds Anya Ruka open underneath.
Bennett fires for three. Set a school record this year in terms of made threes. That one a misfire. Giron took his eyes off it. Hicklin tiptoeing the sideline. Back come the Pointers. Deadlocked at five, nearly 5 minutes in. Krull rooted in the lane. In on the follow.
Offensive rebounding, one of the most underrated parts of basketball. All teams have games where the ball doesn't go in the hoop on the initial attempt. Second shots are big if teams are going to win.
Krull with a team high, game high five in the early going of the men's Division III National Championship contest. Halbin banged away from the low block there. Moss doing the job defensively. Hicklin's lead, finding an open Calso.
Well, great pass by Hicklin. This young redshirt freshman is getting better each and every game.
Pointers fans getting up on their feet. 9-5 for the top-ranked team in Division III in the nation. McAllister zips it inside for Anya Ruka. Shot clock to 10. Giron with a little baseline shake. And he was bumped on his way to the basket. Break time for us, 5 minutes, 43 seconds in. One of the top players in the nation loves to run the floor. That's Jason Calso. He converts, giving the Pointers the early lead.
Hey, Nelly, what's happening?
Tim, what up?
Running to you everywhere.
Yeah, over and over again, huh? See, country boys doing it big. Where you headed?
Heading home.
Oh.
Ah.
Yo.
Take care, bro.
Up.
Yeah, baby, I'll be home soon.
Just sitting down.
Take a minute to breathe. And then I'll...
I think that's you, buddy.
Shooting better than 54% in the last half dozen games. They have been excelling offensively in the tournament. Nick Bennett is one of the primary reasons why, working under the direction of his father, Jack, got to be very, very special to have a father-son relationship and have it produce championships.
Well, it's got to be exciting for the whole Bennett family. There's Nick on the bench with two fouls early Great advantage now for Rochester, but what a great family. His brother, of course, Dick, who's the head coach at Washington State. His nephew, Tony, now at Washington State, who played in the NBA. And, of course, his niece, Kathy, former head coach in Indiana. Just a terrific family and a great basketball family at that.
So many of those friends and family in attendance today, including older son, Jay, who was a former pointer in his own right. Drove all night from Des Moines, Iowa to get here. John Onyeka converts for Rochester. It's his second basket, bringing the Yellow Jackets within two.
Key matchup down on this end as well, Joe. Seth Halpin is guarding Jason Calso. Let's see if the pointers go to Calso to see if they can get Halpin in foul trouble.
Well, one thing we have to notice, John Krull is getting a steady diet of interior looks.
Well, they're a great passing team. The pointers have 487 assists and only 317 turnovers. One of the best passing teams I've ever seen, and particularly their big people. They're terrific passing the ball.
Gabe Perez will keep it on the perimeter. Pointers on the lead by four and dressed in gold. We're in Salem, Virginia today. Krull doing it all with his hands in the passing lane. Hicklin, a baseline drive shut off by Perez. The pointers reverse the basketball very well. Good interior look. That's Calso double clutching. Halpin, one of the national leaders in rebounds. He averages better than a dozen a game.
Well, Calso caught it in great position, but Halpin goes straight up. Principle of verticality. Doesn't reach down or foul, and it's tough for anybody to go over a 6'7 player like Halpin.
Mike Neer, the head coach for the Yellow Jackets, said it was very, very difficult to simulate this pointer zone. Right now, his guys are trying to figure it out, trying to find some seams. As Halpin was shadowed on the end line. It'll stay Rochester ball.
Well, Calso catches it on a straight cut, but Halpin goes straight up and uses his size to bother the shot by Calso. If Calso continues, Joe, to catch the ball in that low, he will score most of the time.
Yeah, he can burn you. 20 points last night. Averages 19 points on the season per game. He has never missed the starting lineup since coming to Stevens Point, Wisconsin. Approaching the 8-minute mark, first half, Division III Men's Basketball Championship game on CSTV. Rochester in possession. Perez gives it out to another three-point threat. That's Tim Brackney. Brackney with four on the shot clock. Front rims it.
Well, the Yellow Jackets are going to have to knock down threes if they're going to win here today. In their four losses, they are only shooting 22% from three.
Calso lobs it inside for Krull, backing down on the defender, and that has been an awfully tough cover for Joe Canty. 11-7, Stevens Point in the driver's seat, very, very early on in Salem, in front of the Yellow Jacket fans.
It's true. The owners of 40 million different cars in America all night.
4,300, and it has been a team that has been a regular in these parts at this time of year.
Well, Mike, near 29 years at one school. Incredible. 476 wins. We'll get to the 500 plateau next year, Joe. 10 appearances in the NCAA Division III tournament. A truly outstanding mentor and coach of young people.
He made so many good points to us earlier in the day as Krull knocks down the free throw. John Krull is up to a game-high 8. Already at his seasonal average.
Well, the pointers are going back into their 3-2 zone. Very tall, athletic, difficult to score against. However, Rochester's being very patient and is controlling the tempo versus this zone. I believe this favors the Yellow Jackets.
You take the words right out of my mouth, Eddie. Mike was telling us earlier, Coach Neer, that his team doesn't mind a half-court game, and that's what they wanted to try and do against Wisconsin Stevens Point. Brackney rising up. Tim Brackney hit 3 of 5 from downtown last night in the win over Calvin.
And two of those were huge in the second half when the Yellow Jackets got out to their lead.
And that was a really hot stretch for him. Around the midway mark of the second half, turned the game in the favor of the Yellow Jackets. Earlier today, Calvin won the third place game.
A nice move here by the Yellow Jackets. They go zone because Nick Bennett, the best three-point shooter for the Pointers, is saddled with 2,000, is not in the basketball game.
He's been out of the lineup the last 3 minutes. From the perimeter, that's Ryan Mee, a heavily braced left knee. Ryan Mee, quite a story in the lineup for the University of Rochester. This player is playing with a completely torn ACL.
Well, I've had young men tear their ACL when I was a coach for 15 years, Joe, and I've never heard of a young man playing with a torn ACL. That generally is an injury that sidelines you for 9 months.
Got hurt in September, and he was supposed to have surgery in mid-October, but all of a sudden, during his rehab, he started to feel better. And he proved it to the trainers and the medical staff, and they said, you know what? If you can deal with it, deal with it.
Well, I don't think anyone's questioning his toughness, do you?
No, not at all. Jerron looking for three. Oh, Halvin, wonderful offensive rebound. And the stick foul.
Well, the senior All-American working the offensive boards. The zone is limiting his touches at the low post. So what does Halpin do? He gets on the offensive board and gets an easy basket.
His first on the day. Halfway through the opening half, Division III Men's Basketball Championship game from and Salem, Virginia on CSTV.
Excuse me, Joe, and Bennett is back in with two fouls.
Fading away there, he was nudged by Ryan Mee, the senior from Hilton, New York.
Good offensive rebounders have great hands and tremendous anticipation, and then the willingness to work the offensive board. Halpin gets another two for the Yellow Jackets.
So dependable, Seth Halpin, this senior from Newton, Massachusetts. The rebounding story favoring the Yellow Jackets slightly. He's led the team in scoring each of the last 3 years. Kyle Grzynski at the top there, 25 in the gold. Good showing from him last night. Kelso all the way. They'll wash out the basket. No basket. Kelso thought he should have had the three-point play chance.
Well, even though that basket was taken away, you can see the quickness and the ability to pound the ball to the floor and get to the hole. Kelso can do it all.
National champs a season ago, Wisconsin Stevens Point. Record-setting year, 29 victories. A win today would equal that mark. Looking for the quick cut inside. Kelso got ripped off. Brackney riding back for the Yellow Jackets. The pull-up three.
Wow, a contested three. They're in his face. It doesn't matter as Brackney docks down another big tray.
13 points yesterday. He's got six on the day today, and Rochester vaults to the lead. Kelso looking to erase that. Oh! Anya Ricca took that off the glass. Wonderful athleticism.
Most athletic play I've seen here this weekend in Salem. He just swiped it above the square.
Yellow Jackets feeding off some momentum now. Good hands by Grzynski. The transfer from the University of Wisconsin tips it out of bounds. Substitutions coming on. It'll be Eric Snyder for the Yellow Jackets.
Well, Kelso can wheel and create angles, but Anna Yuruka comes across, Joe, and just pins it on the board. Great block by the freshman.
He'll cool his heels for a moment. They tell us he's very active on the offensive glass. It has been Rochester in the last couple of minutes, really cranking it up. Takeaway for Grzynski, and a solo waltz.
Well, the Pointers have a sixth man they can go to. Grzynski is just getting better, better, and better. A fifth-year senior, as you indicate, a transfer from the University of Wisconsin. Very experienced.
That was Tamaris Relaford on the bench leading the cheers. The senior would love to be out there finishing his career with his teammates, but a broken left hand in this tournament prevents him from doing so. Moss, too hot to handle for Crow. It was ruled to be Pointer's ball, but the officials will confer. Riley, Celestio, and Scipio, and they'll get the call right and give it to Rochester.
Well, playing this 3-2 zone, actually back to the 3-2 zone, back man-to-man, excuse me. Pointers are now going man-to-man, worried about the three-point shooting of the Yellow Jackets.
And perhaps this guy in particular. Rackney on the ball fake. Jerron. The lob entry for Halpin. He volleyballs it to the sideline, and then it was a timeout called in the air by Jeff Jerron, the freshman from upstate New York. 15-all, and Wisconsin Stevens Point ties it up as Grzynski shows off his smarts defensively.
Absolutely well pointed there by the pointers. He knows, he reads the pass, the savvy of Grzynski. He brings it to the table. Excellent play for the easy dunk.
This is a Wisconsin Stevens Point team wearing the gold. Second best in the nation, Eddie, in Division III. They do not give up a lot of points. Central Wisconsin-based Wisconsin Stevens Point.
Well, located 100 miles north of Madison, and of course, some famous alumni. Terry Porter played in the NBA for 17 years or so. Bob Whitson, Sonics president, general manager for Seattle. And how about Lawrence Eggleburger, the former U.S. Secretary of State?
Two teams tuning up for the remainder of this first half. Rochester and Wisconsin Stevens Point deadlocked 15 apiece. Stevens Point won the national title almost a year to the day last year. They beat Williams in dramatic fashion on the 20th of March.
Well, Jack Bennett goes back man to man, and now that he can't play zone, he takes his son Nick Bennett out with two fouls.
That's Eddie Fogler. I'm Joe Beninati. We're with you on CSTV today for the Division III Men's Basketball Championship. Steve Hicklin, calm, cool, and collected, will bring it ahead. Grzynski sees a lot of time at the top offensively. Oh, there's a quick pass inside, and Krull is having a field day.
Well, how many power forwards could make that zip pass for another assist? That's why he is a terrific all-around player. Calso makes the play.
I mean, among so many different records for Jason Calso, he's top three at Wisconsin Stevens Point in assists all time. Rackney for Onyeruka. Geron wants three. Not there. What else can Krull do? He's got 11 points and five boards, and we're nowhere near the end of the first half.
Joe, I look for Calso to take Halpin on and see if they can pick up his second foul. If I'm Calso, I'm driving the ball right at Halpin to see if I can get him in foul trouble.
Calso from deep. Onyeruka protecting the rim. That's the matchup that we should put in the magnifying glass. Those two All-America, first team All-Americas, going after one another. Halpin at the low block, showing off those moves. Rebound belongs to Grzynski. Seth Halpin, 21 in the blue, really came to life in the NCAA tournament when he was a freshman. All he did was throw 39 points and 18 boards in the national semifinals against Elizabethtown. Since then, he's been the headliner. Calso shuffled his feet. It's a travel against Wisconsin Stevens Point. We'll come back for the conclusion of this first half in a moment. A good one brewing in Salem.
In the 1800s, when my great-great-grandfather Adolphus began.
The Hornets have done another wonderful job hosting this Division III semifinal and final weekend here in Salem, Virginia. Division III basketball, Eddie Fogler, you're so familiar with the game at the Division I level. How does it vary from Division I to Division III?
Well, it's much larger, as the graphic indicates, Joe, but these young men are, most of them are paying their own way to go to college. No scholarships here. Most of these student athletes are picking these institutions for the education first. The basketball is just a bonus to them, although they like to compete very much.
In the third place game earlier today, we saw Calvin defeat York in a very, very high scoring affair. This one, if you're just tuning in with us on CSTV, the low scoring variety, as we drift below 6 minutes to go in the opening half. Wisconsin Stevens Point, top ranked in the nation, the defending national champions, leading by two. Gabe Perez has been very, very quiet. So too Seth Halpin. Trying to change that script. Geron, long range miss. The officials say it belongs to Rochester. CSTV's coverage of the men's Division III National Championship game. Rochester and Wisconsin Stevens Point. Along with Eddie Fogler and the rest of the men and women in our crew, I'm Joe Beninati. So glad you've tuned in. The pointers in gold. The Yellow Jackets wearing the blue.
Nick Bennett continues to sit with two fouls. He'll probably ride out the last part of this half on the bench with his dad trying to keep him out of foul trouble.
Nick Bennett, no points and just one shot taken. This is a player who was the most outstanding, the MVP of the tournament a season ago. Halpin going to his left, and he got fouled.
Well, Halpin sets the screen, goes to the block, reverse pivots, and Perez, nice bounce pass, feeding pass. Gabe Perez has three assists for every turnover. Outstanding assist error ratio by the senior point guard.
Eddie Steve Hicklin just picked up his first. It sends Halpin to the free throw line. And Seth, there on the year is just a 53% free throw shooter. Brackney gets in, Jaron checks out. So the big fella bringing Rochester back even with Wisconsin Stevens Point. 5 minutes to go in the opening half. This has been the man who's having a real red letter day. John Krull, 34 in the goal. Calso working the baseline.
Pointers in their five-man motion. Five players passing, cutting, and setting screens. No set plays. They just use their savvy for the game of basketball on the offensive end of the court.
Very precise in their passing. Calso's three stays true.
Well, if Calso's knocking down threes, it's about over. He's a 49% three-point shooter, Joe, but has only taken 84 on the year.
Conference Player of the Year, Jason Calso, in the rough, tough Wisconsin Intercollegiate Athletic Conference. Nine schools making up that group. The Pointers in front by three, as we remind you, for live stats and game recaps from all rounds of every championship. Go to NCAAsports.com, NCAAsports.com, the official online home for all 88 NCAA championships. NCAAsports.com, lots of facts and figures, and Rochester coach Mike Neer was telling us earlier in the day about the value of the internet for his school with respect to recruiting. Perimeter jumper, and that is the specialty of the house for Brendan McAllister, his first triple on the day.
Well, McAllister, Joe, has only taken 242 shots, of which 210 have been from three. 87% of his attempts from beyond the arc.
You talked with both coaches about their recruiting budgets and all, and I thought it was interesting to hear Neer say about the value of the internet with respect to cluing in prospective student athletes at these Division III schools.
Well, it's a great form of communication, as we all know.
Perez on the push. Brackney accelerating in there. And then Perez says, let's slow down. Gabe Perez, a finalist for the Bob Cousy Award for the top collegiate point guard last year. Easy to see why. And this is a guy who had to leave school at the beginning of the season, 31 in blue, for personal reasons. Came back to campus just after Christmas and has been wonderful.
Well, they go 6-2 without him and probably develop better as a basketball team and then get him back, and it's even better now.
Brzezinski and the Pointers on the takeaway. A leisurely job back up court. Just a little more than 3 minutes to go in the opening half. And the officials spot the foul. Robert Riley blowing his whistle. Brendan McAllister is one to watch from the outside. If you don't believe me, just watch that high arcing jumper. Continue low scoring in Salem, Virginia. Nice day for the family to come on out to the Salem Civic Center. Rochester and Wisconsin Stevens Point, deadlock at 20. Stick around with us at the half. We'll break away back to the field house, check other goings on around the world of sports. It is very, very busy throughout the men's Division I tournament. We'll have a women's Division III recap. Milliken and Randolph-Macon, one of those women's team was going to be a first-time champion at the NCAA Division III level today. Find out who that is with our gang back at the field house. Set play on the inbounds for John Krull. And Krull, well into double digits. He's got 13.
Well, and Jack Bennett says, son, you're a smart basketball player. I'm going to put you back in with two fouls. Nick Bennett back in with 2:50 to go.
That's one thing Jack was telling us earlier in the day, that he, as a head coach, had to trust the instincts of his shooters. And I would imagine that Nick was being a little bit more persuasive on the bench. Hey, Dad, hey, Coach, get me back in there.
Well, and Nick had the assist on that out-of-bounds play a minute ago.
Back comes Rochester, trailing by two. Halpin, very good at moving the ball around the perimeter, kicking it out from inside to outside. Brackney was fouled with a hand by Grzynski. Both Grzynski and Jack Bennett, disbelievers there.
Well, the zone again has slowed the tempo down. It's allowed Rochester to control the tempo. Rochester on the year has shot 19 threes per game. They've already taken 14 in the first half versus the pointer zone.
55-year-old Jack Bennett, 19 years as a high school coach before this pointer's assignment. The thrill of coaching both sons at Wisconsin-Stevens Point. Both Jay, who was the class of 2001, and Nick Bennett, who will graduate this spring. Brackney, I love his touch. So smooth.
And how about the athleticism? He not only can shoot the three, but he can put it down and jump up and make the mid-range shot also.
The Rochester team that bolted out to a 19-game win.
Fake and get into the lane and make mid-range jump shots. Very athletic play by Brackney.
We told you about his 13-point performance an evening ago in the national semifinal game against Calvin. The average is just 5 on the season. He's already got 8 today. A little less than 90 seconds to go in the opening half on CSTV. This is the Division III men's championship game. Bennett crowded on the perimeter. Calvin right there in his grill. Getting a step, Kelso scored and a foul.
Well, the senior All-American catches it outside the three, and he blows by Halpin and takes on Anaruka and attacks the rim and gets fouled for the three-point chance.
It's Anaruka's first personal. Kelso converts at the line. He's got 8. Hicklin gets back in off the bench. Sussex, Wisconsin native. How many fans would you imagine today watching all around the state of Wisconsin? Little towns like Auburndale, Stevens Point, Marshall, Sussex, Seymour. They've all had their eyes focused today, wondering if their pointers can go back-to-back with D3 championship. Become the first team since 99 to do it. Ryan Mee drains the three.
Well, Ryan Mee with the bad knee knocks down another three. 120 attempts for the year, only 110 from three. A great three-point shooter for the Yellow Jackets.
And he's got plenty of student support in the stands. The University of Rochester tangling with Wisconsin Stevens Point in what has been a very, very well-played basketball game. Deadlock now at 25, thanks to this.
Well, and thanks to a collapsing defense on the All-American Halpin. Halpin's smart enough to know when he's catching the ball at the medium to low post, the double and triple teams are going to come. So what do smart players do, Joe? They kick it out to the open shooters.
Eddie coming up next, an automatic bid into this year's NCAA tournament at stake. CSTV Hockey continues its coverage. The only nationally televised hockey schedule in the country. ECAC Hockey live from Pepsi Arena in Albany. CSTV Hockey coming up next. It will be Cornell against Harvard and a wonderful goaltending duel between a pair of Hobie Baker Award finalists. David McKee for Cornell, a 1.24 goals against average. Harvard's Dove Grummet Morris, 949 save percentage. Don't expect many goals in that one that's coming up. ECAC Hockey on CSTV coming next.
Well, the pointers have the ball. There's a 9-second differential between the game clock and the shot clock. It will guarantee Rochester one more possession if they can rebound a missed shot.
Hicklin will survey the defensive field for Rochester. Bennett comes out high to get it. Krull has been the first half scoring hero. An open look for Hicklin, and he makes no mistake.
Well, Hicklin only a 20% three-point shooter, not his forte. The redshirt freshman stepping up big here in his first national championship game.
Gabe Perez not in the ball game right now. 6 seconds in the half. Jaron working off the screen. Brackney with one to go. Oh, that was nearly down as Tim Brackney just missed, fired from three. 28 25. Wisconsin Stevens Point at the break, and Krull nearly half of his gang's points. Now let's pause, go to New York and join Adam Zucker for a breakaway at the Fieldhouse. We'll get you back to Salem after these halftime intermissions activities. And Adam taking it away.
Hey, Adam Zucker here at the CSTV Fieldhouse. Halftime of our D3 title game between the University of Rochester and the Wisconsin Stevens Point Pointers. Coming up on this breakaway, the latest scores from the D1 guys. And we'll hear from Vermont coach Tom Brennan after the upset of Syracuse. Of course, later tonight, all the highlights from the day's tournament games as we bring you NCAA March Madness highlights on CSTV. Penn Holderness, Matt Daugherty, and Brian.
We are at the half of the men's Division III championship game. Wisconsin Stevens Point trying to defend its D3 title, leading by three against Rochester. You know, as television announcers, we get spoiled by the wonderful work of all the technicians in our TV crew, and it really goes back to the old days of radio for description. I could imagine that fans are huddled around their radios, whether they be in the car or in the living room in small towns in Wisconsin or in upstate New York, listening to Rochester play-by-play man J.C. DeLasse and Wisconsin Stevens Point play-by-play guy Scott Krieger. So why don't we share some of their words in half number one.
Jason into the lane, down the lane, lays it home with a foul. What? What are they going to call now? Inbound it will go here to Geron. Off the top of the circle. Gives it back off to Eric Snyder, who's into the game. Stolen away, Kyle Grzynski, breakaway down to the other end. He'll dunk it.
Now to Perez at the top. Gabe, bounce it here to Brackney, right wing. Brackney for three, it's up, good. Brackney on the move with a hand up on him, and he drills the running three. E, Brackney will try a three from the left side, good. Oh man, with a crossover dribble, and he had actually two defenders on him, and he still hit the three.
Great stuff from J.C. DeLasse and Scott Krieger. As we are courtside with them on the television side, Joe Beninati and Eddie Fogler, that is Scott Krieger, the man who has called a lot of wins for Wisconsin Stevens Point this year. Eddie, as a Division I head coach, you've hit the recruiting trail on a number of different cities, some of them very, very small ones. What's basketball like in those fine little enclaves?
Well, Friday night, the whole town and community goes to the basketball game, Joe. When I was at Vanderbilt, I was lucky enough to recruit successfully Frank Secker from Oshkosh, Wisconsin, where Division III University of Wisconsin Oshkosh is located. Terrific basketball. Frank grew up playing with the Division III players. It consumes the whole community. Of course, Bo Ryan, very successful at Wisconsin, now has a number of small-town Wisconsin players in his program. And, of course, the upstate area has produced some awfully good players for Syracuse and Niagara and the University of Buffalo and so forth.
Two teams starting to get back to the court for the start of the second half. Before we get to that, Eddie, what should we expect to see from an alteration standpoint, perhaps some changes going on in the second half?
Well, Bennett and Haslow have got to get into the game. They had 54 points last year in the championship game, only have eight at halftime. And the other end of the court, Rochester, if they can shoot the ball well from three, can win this basketball game.
And Gabe Perez has been held remarkably quiet. No points in the first half. That is likely to change in half number two. And they'll be ready to sing them home to a championship title here in Salem.
Setting your sights on, and when you see it, will you be ready? Just pick up the phone, dial 1-800-645-ARMY, and you'll get this free DVD. You'll learn about the hundreds of opportunities the Army can offer you. Skills, education, health care. Call 1-800-645-ARMY, and you'll also get this free boonie hat. Whatever you're looking for, the Army can help you find it.
Ever since I won all that money on Jeopardy.
What is stinking rich?
I've had a lot of relatives.
so fan club. Jason, the senior, who's finishing his basketball playing career at the Division III level. Brad, the freshman who broke all of Big Brother's high school marks, is just starting his Stevens Point career. Wisconsin Stevens Point, the halftime break, leading by three. Other numbers, Eddie, and we should focus on the points inside.
Well, inside, 18 points in the paint for Wisconsin Stevens Point, only four for Rochester. However, the other side of that, Rochester has five threes versus only two for Wisconsin Stevens Point. Interestingly enough, Nick Bennett averaging almost 19 points a game, comes up with no points in the first half, but only played 10 minutes. Of course, bench points, Rochester's bench doing a great job as Brackney comes off the bench and is huge with 8 points in the first half.
Big numbers for him, even bigger for John Krull. 13 points, five boards. Tom Calso perhaps praying to the heavens and hoping for a little divine inspiration to see if Wisconsin Stevens Point can win back-to-back national championships at the Division III level. They out-dueled Williams and Eastman standout Michael Crotty a season ago. It was Nick Bennett and Jason Calso who were heroic in that effort.
And Rochester is in a box-and-one defense on Nick Bennett, trying to keep Bennett out of the game. Again, he's scoreless in the first half, trying to take him out for the whole game.
Right away, Calso says, follow me for three. He's got 11. Wisconsin Stevens Point ended the first half on a 6-0 run, so that's nine unanswered now for the guys in gold. Rochester, the university thereof, the Yellow Jackets, wearing the blue today. Perez, good bounce pass, and Halbin made that look easy.
Well, and Perez shows you what dribble penetration can do. He gets into the lane, the defense must help, and the nice bounce pass for the easy basket by Halbin.
Halbin was the sectional MVP last weekend, earning Rochester a chance to come to the national semifinals. Bennett, unselfishly, nice little dish for Eric Moss.
Well, how many guys do you know who get 19 points a game, give away a layup for an easier layup for a teammate? Very unselfish by Nick Bennett.
And Eddie, usually it's Moss, the big guy, who is very, very good with respect to assists to turnover ratio. How often do you see a center lead his conference in that stat?
Well, hardly ever, if ever. And Calso as well has a tremendous assist error ratio. Great pair of passing big men, Joe.
Just getting started in the second half. Really enjoying this one between Rochester and Wisconsin Stevens Point. The student athletes in Division III. There is no athletic financial aid. These guys are not scholarship players. The likelihood of them going pro is very, very remote with respect to only the best of the best maybe getting a chance to play in Europe. Nick Bennett, cool, as a cucumber in the lane.
Well, Bennett just jumps up over the smaller McAllister for his first basket of the game. Let's see if that's a start of a big second half for Nick.
The lead is six, and you know you're a good scorer when you can pass Terry Porter on the Wisconsin Stevens Point scoring list. That's something Bennett did recently. Geron for three. Halbin will give the Yellow Jackets another whack.
Nice pass out again by Halpin. He's getting double team at the low post, but his teammates are going to have to knock down the open threes if they have a chance to win here.
Perez, the point guard. More pulling guard, according to his head coach, Mike Neer, a guy who benches better than 300. Number 31 in the blue. A wonderful little wrap pass inside for Anya Rooker. And Calso was all over his neck.
And how about the good sportsmanship as Calso goes over to Anaruka and apologizes for a pretty tough foul. The nice bounce pass, feeding pass. The angle is created by Anaruka. And Calso comes over the top with a pretty hard but unintentional foul and then apologizes.
Eddie, you talked about young men who love to be coached. At this level, you get a lot of those kinds of athletes. And Mike Neer was explaining that to us, that this is such a joy for a Division III head coach when you get guys who buy in.
Well, they buy in, Joe. They understand what the coach is trying to do. They're, for the most part, when I coached in Vanderbilt, my players were all smarter than I was, and I had to be very careful what I said to them, because if I contradicted myself, they would remember it 3 years down the road.
Right as a whip. McAllister misses for three, and someone like Brendan McAllister, who Coach Neer says will be on Wall Street someday. A lot of very smart athletes out there. Nick Bennett starting to heat up at just the right moment. That's a triple for the 6'5 senior from Stevens Point.
Almost a 45% three-point shooter. Doesn't have great range on his three-point shot, but he can bang them home.
Largest lead on the afternoon. They love it in purple and gold. And Mike Neer brings play to a halt and asks for time.
Well, Nick Bennett, scoreless at halftime, gets the nice pitch ahead pass and uses the size to jump up and knock down a big three. And the point is off to a 10-point lead early in the second half. Step back, Joe. He knew where the three-point line was. Very smart basketball player, a coach's son.
Eddie, how is it that really hard workers like Nick Bennett, front and center in your screen right there, can come on and be, well, not so great high school players and then turn out to be outstanding college ones at this level?
Well, first of all, young men, particularly in basketball, you never know how much more growth and strength can come. A lot of these kids have put on weight, have worked very hard to improve. Who gets better is really crucial. When I was recruiting as a college basketball coach, the intangible quality Joe has, who loved to play the game, who was willing to work during the offseason to improve as a basketball player, very hard to figure out sometimes.
Well, Bennett helped to methodically dismantle York last night. You're watching CSTV coverage of the Division III Men's Basketball Championships. Along with Eddie Fogler, I'm Joe Beninati. Rochester in the blue. Brackney hoisting up the three, followed up by Onyeka.
Well, the big fella aggressively attacking the offensive board. A much-needed basket for the Yellow Jackets.
He's 6'7", Eddie, and in soccer, coaches always talk about having a target midfielder. This guy was a central midfielder in soccer in high school at 6'7". I bet you could find him easy.
That'd be pretty scary to look at, would it not?
Definitely. Brendan McAllister picks up the foul as we go back to the offensive end and Onyeka.
Well, the big fella set a down screen at the foul line for the shooter and then works his way to the basket because he knew the jump shot was going up and the anticipation and the desire to get to the offensive board for the easy two.
Nick Bennett to the free throw line. Ho-hum,
ho-hum.
90%. 90.
Is that all?
That's all. Bennett. All six of his points coming in the second half. Bump it up by one.
And that only ranks him fifth in the nation in Division III basketball.
Right.
So how about the other four youngsters who are shooting better than 90%
good
in the free throw line?
Good. Bennett averaged 24 points a game in last year's tourney run, which ended in a title for Wisconsin-Stevens Point, trying to back it up today against Rochester, leading by 10. Onyeka, little baby hook there. Calso cleans up the glass.
And the pointers have gone straight man-to-man in the second half. Now, Bennett only two fouls, trying to stay away from his third. They're trying to create the tempo. Also, and additionally, they're trying to take away the three-point shot from the Yellow Jackets.
Bennett just climbed the list in the Wisconsin all-time scoring totals. Follows his own shot. Score it in one.
A tough, tough matchup. How many 6'5 big guards are there in any division of college basketball? Just backs the defender in, misses a pretty easy shot, but stays after it and gets it back in the hoop.
Wisconsin Stevens Points fans have to love what they're seeing. Their team is starting to open it up. Mike Neer and gang, they need the recovery.
You suffer from March sadness. Hi, I'm Dan Leeds. Every year, millions of fans can't watch all the tournament games they'd really like to see, triggering fits of rage, sadness, and a general malaise. But there is a cure. With the NCAA March Madness on Demand, you can watch every game not televised in your region live on your computer. So end March sadness once and for all.
NCAA March Madness on Demand, powered by CSTV.com, is presented by the first-ever G6 and Pontiac, official performance machines of the NCAA.
Throughout the NCAA.
Some breathing room, leading by 12. Make sure to tune into CSTV after all the day's games are complete for NCAA March Madness highlights on CSTV. It's the official highlight show of the NCAA Men's Basketball Tournament. Our experts breaking down the day's game. NCAA March Madness highlights on CSTV tonight and tomorrow. Just a tournament summary from the Division I ranks. What a night it was. A bad night for Kansas and Syracuse. And at the bottom, very interesting to us, Eddie, Bucknell against Wisconsin. A couple of D3 champions matching up there.
Well, Pat Flannery and Bo Ryan, Division III national championship coaches, worked their magic at the Division III level and now working that same magic at the Division I level. It just says to me, Joe, if you can coach, you can coach. It doesn't matter what level you're coaching at.
Gabe Perez trying to sort out things offensively for the Yellow Jackets of the University of Rochester. We approach the five-minute mark of the second half. Brackney, he loved that little quick crossover dribble to get his shot started. On Yoruka, rejected by Calso, but we hear the whistle. Officials today, Riley, Celestio, and Scipio getting into the act.
We heard that whistle, Joe. That looked clean to me. As Anaruka takes it along the baseline, and Calso comes from the backside and gets all ball.
It is his third personal. John Yoruka at the free throw line this season, just 50%. Missed the first one badly.
And let's see if Rochester goes back at Calso next time down the floor. A senior, a smart player. Coach Bennett's keeping him in the game, hoping his senior can play without fouling. I would get him out for a quick breather, just a 1 or 2 minute breather to explain the situation to him. However, but Coach Bennett knows his personnel better than I do.
Gabe Perez got the offensive glass there, practically fell on his lap. Rochester, after the two missed free throws, looking to get it inside to Hauben at all costs. Kicking it back out. Brackney on the perimeter. They hustle for it on the floor. Brackney, wonderful tip back for Perez. It's three consecutive possessions.
Great hustle play by both teams.
Open look, Perez, and a friendly roll.
And loose balls. We used to chart them. Count the loose balls in a game and see how many your team gets. Generally, the team that gets more than the other wins the basketball game.
Perez had 12 points last night in the win over Calvin. That was just his first points on the day, and we see again the bodies flying along the baseline. Gabe Perez, the 5'11 senior, he has three personals.
Joe, you think these young men want to tear down the nets after this game? Look at the effort by both teams, and Rochester finally comes up with it, and Perez makes a two-point shot, right at the foul line area.
Gabe Perez, who was hit in the eye in the first half last night in their win over Calvin. And Calvin, by the way, winning in the third place game earlier today in this national semifinals weekend. They got the better of York College of Pennsylvania. What a year it was for York. A single season school record. They finish up with 28 victories. Mike Neer's gang from Rochester into today, 25-4. And he was lamenting earlier to us that his team has not had a lot of chances to host any Sweet 16 games. 8 years they've been in that round and only hosted once.
And you could tell that he was somewhat upset that they didn't have the home court advantage in a number of years when he thought he had one of the best teams in the country.
Well, he downed, and he and his team downed Amherst, the number two team in the country, at Amherst. It was a very, very bitter pill for the Lord Jeffs to swallow.
And Amherst was undefeated this year at home.
Inside, Moss was flashing loose. Foul before the shot. It goes against Onyeruka. It's his second. Talking about Rochester and the way they've advanced through the bracket, a bye in the regional, and then they turned it on.
Well, the Amherst went on the road. A great, great win. Very difficult to beat Amherst in their building.
This is Rochester, the University of Rochester of the University Athletic Association. Long triple from the outside. Nick Bennett is seeing the basket very, very well right now.
And that one was just put in the face of the Rochester defender, Joe Canty.
All 12 of his points, Eddie, all 12 of Nick Bennett's points have come in the second half. This is Canty on the basketball.
Well, with a 13-point lead, they go back to the zone, not worried about the tempo slowing now, and Calso is on the bench with three fouls.
Brackney doesn't hit. He's now 2 of 7 from three this evening as we hear the whistle. Steve Hicklin, who made his first college start against Puget Sound in the D3 tourney, in this D3 tourney, due to the injury to Tamaris Relaford, the senior point guard, wonderful defender for the Pointers. It has been a nice ride for Hicklin since joining the starting lineup. As Onyeruka hits at the free throw line. 45-33, Wisconsin Stevens point. approach the 7-minute mark on CSTV. You're enjoying the men's Division III National Championship game. There's Tamaris Relaford, that bandaged left hand keeping him out of the lineup. Great look for Moss as Bennett was sightseeing.
Well, one of the best passing teams I've seen at any level. The Wisconsin Stephen Point basketball team can pass it, and they are extremely unselfish. Great look by Nick Bennett.
Hitting on all cylinders now, as the cliche would go. Canty in the Yellow Jackets need to get some points from Seth Halvin. Good look, good distribution. Charon doesn't hit. Bauer commanding the glass, the 6'5 junior from Auburndale, Wisconsin. Things are starting to get away from the Yellow Jackets right now.
Well, Halvin is being double teamed, continuing to kick it out. It is the right play, but his teammates have not been able to knock down threes.
Rochester needs a stop here. This is a Rochester team that hasn't allowed 80 points in the last 58 games. But my goodness, is Nick Bennett on a roll.
Well, he might not have scored in the first half, but he's going to probably get his average in the second half, Joe.
Just sensational. The school record holder for three-point baskets averages 18-3 a game. Was blanked in the first half, and all he's done is rack up 15 in half number two. Onyeka hit on the arm on his way to the rim. Wisconsin Stevens Point, there's plenty of good stuff to go around. An unselfish nature on this team, leading to easy baskets and a big lead.
We are the men and women of the United States Army Reserve. We live in big cities and small towns. We are regular people who have taken a...
Wisconsin Stevens Point defeated defending champion Williams last year. This year they try to defend themselves. Brzezinski will keep it on the outside for long stretches last night. Brzezinski acted as the point guard. Kroll continuing his marvelous day.
And many of Kroll's baskets, Joe, have been off a terrific feed. That time the center, Eric Moss, a terrific 6'9 passer. How about the passing ability of Moss and this entire pointer basketball team? A pretty thing to watch.
3.2 assists for every turnover for Moss this year. That is a very, very good stat for a center. The senior from Green Bay, as they are picking apart Rochester's defense.
And the pointers now have no player on the court under 6'4". This is one of the bigger zones in America out here.
Turnover. Crawl away to the races. Oh, marvelous effort there. Perez hustling back. But it was going to be Crawl undaunted.
Well, the active zone, the long arms, the anticipation of smart basketball players. Steals lead to easy baskets when you turn it over out front. And unfortunately, Rochester has done that too much here today.
What is it about this floor that enlivens the game of John Crull? Jack Bennett watched John score 25 against John Carroll on this court in the national semis a year ago. He's got 17 today. 54-35 Wisconsin Stevens Point, and we tell you, for the complete television broadcast schedule for all NCAA championship games available in your area, head for NCAAsports.com. NCAAsports.com, the official online home for all 88 NCAA championships. Mr. Calso has to appreciate the work of his sons today and also that of their teammate Nick Bennett, who has found his shooting stroke in the second half.
Well, he has taken over in the second half, using his size to back down smaller defenders, and now beyond the arc, he has gotten his confidence back. Nick Bennett just taking it over on the offensive end and making tough shots and easy shots for the pointers.
Trying to win today for Wisconsin Stevens Point, and trying to win game number 200 for Jack Bennett As a head coach at Wisconsin Stevens Point, now 9 seasons worth, as we return you to the live action, just more than 10 minutes to go in the second half. Rochester needs to get its act in order in a hurry. And usually when that is demanded, they keep the ball in the hands of 31, Gabe Perez. McAllister 3, short. Hustling, it's Ryan Mead. Giving McAllister another look. Same result. Anya Ruka, no. Halvin working feverishly, and this will stay Rochester ball. Well, he's really a bloodhound inside. He was the first guy Jack Bennett was talking to us about today. Seth Halvin and how they were going to defend him. Anya Ruka got loose in the lane.
Well, at the Division III level, you don't see a lot of doubling down the post players like you do perhaps at another level. However, at the shoot-around today, Jack Bennett has so much respect for Halpin. He talked about doubling down, wanting to take the ball out of the leading scorer's hands for the Yellow Jackets and making his teammates beat the pointers from three.
And Eddie Jason Calso, we see him off in the distance behind Halpin there for a moment, has now been saddled with 4 personals. So the top dog for the pointers, if you will, pardon the pun, scolding himself on the way to the bench.
Well, but Bennett has been able to play the entire second half with no fouls and still only has 2 for the game. So they're in good shape with Bennett still on the court.
Anya Ruka into double digits. It was 3 for 3 last night when Rochester downed the Knights of Calvin. This Rochester school, coming from that University Athletic Association, Carnegie Mellon, Chicago, Brandeis, Case Western, some of the finest academic institutions in the land.
Incredible schools, and a lot of flying, a lot of airplane travel in Rochester's league. The point is, do a lot of bus travel in the state of Wisconsin.
Shot clock at 4. Crow says, follow me.
Well, it's obvious the power and the strength of this Wisconsin Stevens Point team, way too much for Rochester here today.
9 points yesterday for Krull, 10 better than that today, 19 right now, and we are nowhere near this game's conclusion. Still plenty of time, and the lead grows to 20. Anya Ruka, splash.
The young freshman showing a lot of potential here in the championship game, much more active than he was last night.
Give him 14 now. Yes, Kyle Grzynski will walk it ahead. Ryan Bauer is into the game. Big guy really gets busy in the lane. Not afraid to crank it up from behind the arc.
Grzynski at point guard at 6'5 for the pointers.
Makes good decisions. Bauer's 3. Bullseye.
Well, Brian Bauer looks like a power forward or a defensive tackle, but has great touches. He shoots 45% from 3 for the year.
That was the first thing you noticed today, Coach, when you were watching the shoot around. He's got a nice release as Halvin was fouled on his way to the rack.
Well, Bauer played only 3 minutes in the championship game last year, playing many more minutes this year. The great release, he gets his feet set. Terrific rotation. Excellent shooter for a young man that size.
Just as Rochester has gone cold, they have just a couple of points in the last 4 minutes. As we see the Yellow Jackets going to the bench, Eric Snyder, the sophomore from upstate New York, taking out John Anya Ruka. Snyder, who was very helpful to Rochester in the Sweet 16 and the Elite 8 game wins. We'll see Dan Milbrand, a freshman, get in off the bench. And Seth Halvin. A seat on the pine, Halvin, just 8 points today.
Juniors in a 5-man motion, just pass and cut, good court balance, spacing, excellent screening action, of course, the outstanding passing in a very unselfish manner, very difficult to guard.
We were watching the both teams go through their morning shoot-arounds, and we were eavesdropping as the assistant coaches were spelling out different defensive assignments, and both coaches were saying that neither team's offense did a lot of standing around. There was a lot of movement. There wasn't a lot of laziness out on that perimeter.
Well, Joe, when 5 players are moving, and the ball is moving with screening action, it is very difficult to guard good motion. Some teams believe in many more set plays. As a coach, I was a motion coach and always felt that motion was much tougher to guard than set plays. Both these teams run very good motion offense.
Jeff Geron leading the Yellow Jackets back ahead. McAllister, the hero yesterday. Three-pointer late against Calvin. Another turnover for the Jackets. Not what they need, trailing by more than 20 with less than 8 to go.
Well, Joe, new NCAA rule. The Pointers actually played an exhibition game against the Marquette Warriors early this year. We're down 4 points with 7 minutes to go in Milwaukee and played an NIT team almost even for 34, 35 minutes. It shows you the caliber of this basketball
team. That's really good basketball. They've won their last seven. Their last loss came in mid-February against Wisconsin Oshkosh. You know, during the season, they've managed to avenge their losses. They've only lost three times, all to schools within the conference. I mean, they have been absolutely bloodthirsty against non-conference rivals. Ryan Bauer and the Pointers closing in on something special in Salem.
What are you setting your sights on? And when you see it, will you be ready? Just pick up the phone, dial 1-800-645-ARMY, and you'll get this free DVD. You'll learn about the hundreds of opportunities the Army can offer you. Skills, education, health care. Call 1-800-645-ARMY, and you'll also get this free boonie hat. Whatever you're looking for, the Army can help you find it.
Remember the 87 Hoosiers run and this clutch jumper?
Or when Princeton knocked off UCLA with the backdoor play.
Each a game-changing performance.
Now you can help pick the Pontiac game-changing performance of the 2005 NCAA tournament.
Go to ncaasports.com/Pontiac and vote after each round of play.
You'll help decide which schools will win up to $150,000 in general scholarship contributions from Pontiac.
So take action and vote.
Band practice again at 3:30. Someone stole my car.
Hold the phone. I got my boys at Fix-A-Hoopties to trick out your ride. What do you think? It's tight, right?
Okay, that looks exactly the same.
Didn't your mama tell you? It's the inside that counts. Check this out.
Shut up.
Crisp, clean, thirst quenching Sprite, never out of reach. Show them my motto. By the way, you owe $37,000.
There's a lot of pride on this Wisconsin Stevens Point team. Pride in their national championship from a season ago, and they have taken that to arms today. 62-41, they have the lead. Look at the last five D3 champions. Williams tried to defend it last year. The Pointers wouldn't allow it. Now they're trying to do something very, very special.
Well, very, very special, Joe. Only two other schools have been able to do this in the Division III level. Bo Ryan, the great coach, did it here in, 98-99, and North Park actually won three in a row in the late 70s. This would be a just an incredible win, and what a story here for the Pointers.
North Park, a school from the Chicago area, 78, 79, and 80 in their consecutive run, and there you see it here inside of the Salem Civic Center. Wonderful host venue for this men's Division III championship game. They've done it for the last 10 years in this facility, which was opened back in the late 60s. Fans have had a wonderful time during the national semifinal weekend. We've enjoyed our time here with you on CSTV. Brackney gets back in. Geron will have a seat for the Yellow Jackets. If you're just tuning in, Rochester in blue. Wisconsin Stevens Point in the gold. And looking very much like the LA Lakers in those colors.
And Rochester, not a pressing team, forced to now pick up the defense, move it out, and try to come up with some steals. They need some easy baskets and some three-point opportunities.
As Wisconsin Stevens Point looks to drain precious time away from the game clock. Nick Bennett, who's been the shooting star in the second half. Good hands by Halbin. Bauer arcs up the three. They are now 5 of 8 from three in the second half. Rochester, unfortunately for them, 0-for-7 from deep in the second half.
And the 6'5 point guard Krasinski comes up with an offensive rebound over the 5'11 Perez for another opportunity.
How about Wisconsin-Stevens Point, 55-1 in their last 56 against teams from outside their conference. They have made mincemeat of the competition, trying to do that to a very valiant Rochester team today. Jack Bennett prowling the sidelines, very animated. You know, here's something to consider. His son Jay is in the stands. We mentioned him driving all hours of the night from Des Moines, Iowa to see his father and brother play today. He coached Jay, he's coaching Nick. Nick graduates this year. Might he consider a move to another location?
Well, that's hard to say, Joe. I know he's extremely happy where he is. His record speaks for itself. Just a terrific basketball coach. Very emotional after they won it last year. It'll be very interesting to see his reaction if they win this basketball game and get two in a row.
Eddie, I say that only because it's been bandied about that Bruce Pearl at the University of Wisconsin-Milwaukee has been rumored to be moving to another locale. Perhaps there's a shuffling through the ranks in state, in Wisconsin, in the Badger State. But you're exactly right. Jack Bennett is closing in on the 200th victory of his wonderful career. Jason Calso, the conference player of the year, and the Pointers very much in the driver's seat.
Spreading the court, taking time off the clock, try to reset with 10 or so and see if they can get a good shot.
Shot clock to six. Crawl. One of the rare instances that wouldn't stay put.
Excellent possession, however. Get a great look with 2 seconds on the 35-second shot clock.
Back comes Rochester. Brackney forced that one. The Yellow Jackets 19-2 since the start of the calendar year 2005, but they've run into a buzzsaw today. Stevens Point asks for time, leading by 21. 4 minutes, 43 seconds left. If you are just catching up with us on CSTV, why don't we spell out our Pontiac game summary for you. The Pontiac game summary today. Look at the shooting percentage for the Pointers.
Well, when you get the ball in the paint as much as the Pointers have, Joe, you're going to put up great percentages. They have pounded it inside and have used their size. On the other side of the ledger, Rochester has basically had no inside game, relying on the three-point shot almost entirely and unable to make those baskets.
Boy, the kids have had a great time here in Salem during this national semifinals weekend. Band members from nearby John Carroll, they loved their experience so much last year, they decided to come on their own this year.
That tells you it's good, doesn't it?
Real good. Just a wonderful time of year for the college basketball fan. The Calso faithful, hoping to root home Wisconsin-Stevens Point to another championship. Maybe a keepsake or two in that camera from a weekend in Salem. The senior class for Wisconsin-Stevens Point, they provide better than 73% of the offense. They are so reliable, and they have been today. Jason Calso very patient on the outside. The Pointers in no particular hurry, a commanding lead in their favor. Shot clock at seven. Nice up and under by Calso, but it's going to be ruled a travel. There are many who thought, Eddie, that Jason Calso could be the Jostens Award winner this year, but that honor went to J.D. Byers of Lebanon Valley. Calso is the finalist for the award.
Well, his numbers on the offensive end are just staggering to me. 56% from two, 78 at the line, 49 from three. Leads his team in assists from the power forward position. I've never seen that.
He came to Stevens Point, Wisconsin, from the little town in Illinois, Huntley, Illinois. His high school team came and actually performed at a summer camp. That's how they found him. And boy, are they glad that trip was made. Nick Bennett, bullseye.
Bullseye for Bennett and give Calso another assist with a very unselfish perimeter pass to the open Bennett.
18 points for Bennett. Right back at you. It's Tim Brackney. He's got 11 first points in the second half. 67-46 for Wisconsin. Stevens Point. The foul will come here against Brackney. It will send us to commercial break. We will hustle you right back to Salem in just a few moments, where today it has been the Stevens Point team hitting from the outside. Nick Bennett leading the charge.
It's true. The owners of 40 million different cars in America all have one thing in common. They love the personal service and competitive rates they get from their State Farm agent. And they wouldn't drive without one. Find out why more drivers trust State Farm for auto insurance than the next three companies combined.
Throughout the NCAA tournament, you'll be voting for Pontiac's game-changing performances.
You'll help decide which schools will win up to $150,000 in general scholarship fund contributions from Pontiac.
And while online, you can record your voice over your favorite game-changing performance.
And if we pick your play-by-play, you could win a trip to this year's championship game, and you can also register to win one of these new Pontiacs.
So go to NCAAsports.com/Pontiac and vote today.
Because you're calling the action.
Here is for the love of the game. When it's for money, it's not the same. That is why you'll never see owners or agents on CSTV. Football, soccer, and volleyball. We cover 30 sports overall. That is why you should try marching onward to CSTV.
Wisconsin Stevens Point breathing easy. And speaking of that, we should look at our State Farm drive of the game. An uncontested stroll, more like it, for the senior from Seymour, Wisconsin. Kyle Grzynski says thank you very much and has the day's only flush on the night.
I love players who have savvy and anticipation. They know how to play the game, and Grzynski read that the whole way. He was reading it and took it down for the easy dunk.
So many heroes dressed in gold. This will be one of the unsung guys, Kyle Grzynski, the senior who began his college basketball career playing at the Division I level at Wisconsin-Madison, came to town and has really been a nice fit in Stevens Point. Back to the redshirt freshman's travail, Steve Hicklin. He's kicked in a half dozen points today.
Well, the Pointers do have six very good seniors on this basketball team. There's still, Joe, some nice pieces of the puzzle for Jack Bennett and his staff in the future.
Here comes Sean Lee as the coach will get to the bench. Hicklin is the first out to receive the congratulations. Sean Lee, who missed eight games with a broken hand during the season. Remember Tamaris Relliford, one of the leaders, one of the seniors, the point guard, the starter who broke his hand in the tournament. That paved the way for Hicklin. Perez for three. Not there. It'll be Rochester ball.
And as Hicklin comes off the court, Relliford is the first one to meet the freshman point guard. The senior point guard goes up and gives him a bear hug, Joe.
He has been very inspirational today and throughout the national semifinal weekend, cheering his guys on. We hear the whistle, blocking foul. This will go back over to Wisconsin Stevens Point. Mike Neer knows that the end is near. Wasn't it interesting today that he was playing or coaching in front of his former college coach? Mike was a wonderful rebounder at Washington Lee.
Well, Mike is from the state of Virginia, as you indicate. Went to Washington Lee not too far down the road on I-81. Has a lot of family and friends here. A terrific coach. I cannot get over 29 years at one school. How about a statue at the University of Rochester for Coach Neer?
Oh, just phenomenal. The lead is 23 for the Pointers. Looking to tack some more on. Nice rebounding position by Perez. Coach Neer was telling us about a point guard he used to have who was in attendance. Callister drains the three, trying to bring Rochester from well behind. Coach is saying, you know, there's a professor at Georgia Tech, who used to be a point guard of mine, who's going to make the drive down and watch the game today. So many of those stories at the Division III level.
Well, the caliber of the student athlete that these two coaches are working with is outstanding. Most of these young men go on to be very successful people in their chosen profession. And how about the officiating here today, Joe? Very well done by the three men in the striped shirts. Neither coach has really complained about a call at all.
Eddie, that's a nice way to wrap up your college career. Jason Calso with some high-wire pyrotechnics. Just window dressing now for the Pointers as he launches the three. 90 seconds away for Wisconsin Stevens Point. Timeout asked for. You mentioned the officials, Robert Riley, Phil Celestio, and Brian Scipio. A job well done today. The celebration starts to begin on the Wisconsin Stevens Point side.
Well, the senior goes out with a thunder dunk, Joe, as he goes over the top of the Rochester defense.
That's the way to do it.
He can really put it down and explode up. Jason Calso.
15 points today, below his season average, below the 24 he had in the title game last year, but those two were brilliant. Plenty of hugging and holding and handshakes now for the Pointers, who are convincingly ahead. Wisconsin Stevens Point, better than 1,200 wins in their career. Look at what they've done in the state of Wisconsin since 68. And now they are on the verge of a back-to-back milestone. I don't think you could have scripted it any better if you're Jason Calso and you want to finish up just like that.
Well, the entire roster from the state of Wisconsin, except for the Calso brothers from the little town in Illinois.
Coach Jack Bennett is fond of using movie clips to inspire and rally his team. Very fond of movie clips involving Jack Nicholson, a big basketball fan. And it's over! Alley-oop slam! All the stops! Bingo! Owie! The freshman puts it down. A few good men, one flew over the cuckoo's nest. Both of those movie titles in effect going into today's game, and they have performed tremendously.
Now the back screen on Halpin, and they just throw it up to the freshman for the thunder dunk. A highlight reel here the last 2 minutes, Joe.
Look
the Pointers.
At Damaris Relaford. Benga Owie's a guy who made the team on the first day of school, an open tryout. Benga Owie's a guy who was enrolled at Wisconsin-Milwaukee, didn't play there last year, and just made the team, said, you know what, coach, I think I'm good enough to play. And Jack Bennett gave him a spot on the team.
Well, he's good enough to jump out of the gym as well. Very athletic play by the youngster. Again, nice pieces of the puzzle coming back, although there'll be some seniors sorely missed in this Wisconsin Stevens Point basketball program.
Well, a minute and 6 seconds away from that being a fact, that sign. We saw business major for Benga Owie. There are so many different majors. Throughout the four teams in the national semifinals, you had engineering majors, biochemistry majors. These guys, these young men are on the fast track to great things in the non-athletic world. As Rochester asks for time.
And certainly, let's give credit to Mike Neer and his Rochester Yellow Jackets, Joe. Just a terrific season, another great year for their basketball program. A very disappointing loss, however, here today, but this team has played terrific basketball all year.
Eddie, you know, last year, rather this year, the first year that three former champions made the national semifinal. And it is Wisconsin Stevens Point, 43 seconds away from validating a title of a season ago. Shot clock violation against Rochester.
Well, the Pointers in 24 of their 28 wins were by 10 points or more. They've been not beating people, Joe. For the most part, they've been dominating opponents all season.
Really amazing. Only one game all season decided by 5 points or less. They won that one in overtime against Wisconsin La Crosse. The Pointer fans serenading the guys in gold. 14 seconds now. A 1 second disparity on the shot clock as they count it down in Salem. The long three is a misfire. The horn sounds, and off they come.
Excuse me, that just scared the heck out of me, Joe.
The confetti flies, the explosions ring out, and Wisconsin Stevens Point gets right to the point as back-to-back national champs.
Well, the better team won here today. Complete dominance in the paint by the very tall, very solid, outstanding basketball team of Wisconsin Stevens Point. Just too much for Rochester here today. Two in a row, terrific accomplishment for these young student athletes and their coaching staff.
What a day it is for Jack Bennett. What a day it is for Wisconsin Stevens Point. So much to brag about. 73-49. When we come back, we'll talk to the champs. The Stevens Point squad, triumphant in Salem.
This presentation on CSTV is brought to you in part by Sirius Satellite Radio. Want radio your way? Ride with the big dog.
Do you have ingrown toenail?
Constipation.
Hemorrhoids.
Remove back hair.
That little itch.
Say no to B.O.
Commercial. That's why we keep our heads out the window. Buddy, it's time to get serious.
Sirius Satellite Radio. Over 120 channels, including commercial-free music. Want radio your way? Ride with the big dog.
Oh, yeah.
Sirius Satellite Radio. Right now, get a Sirius plug-and-play receiver and docking kit for just $119 after rebate.
The fan sitting here switched his car insurance from Geico to Allstate and saved $318 a year. This one switched from Progressive and saved $476. This one switched from State Farm and saved $214. Just three of the 1 million drivers who switched to Allstate. Out to save America some money. That's Allstate, Stan. Are you in good hands?
Quick, in the top five water polo players in the world. Okay, how about one? Yeah. I didn't start playing water polo until I get famous. And the same goes for being a biology major. I like working in protein chemistry. Quick, in the top five protein chemists in the world.
There are over 360,000 NCAA student athletes. And just about all of us are going pro in something other than sports.
A leader in disaster relief, Mercy Corps is rushing aid to victims of the Asian tsunamis. Millions of people need help now to recover from the worst disaster in modern times. Families and children who survived the tsunamis face disease and homelessness. Your donation will save lives. Help provide life-changing assistance to victims of the Asian tsunamis. Restore their hope. It begins with you. Please call Mercy Corps at 1-800-766-1100 today.
There it is, a pot of gold at the end of the rainbow for Wisconsin Stevens Point. 73-49 victors this evening. Coach Eddie Fogler is standing by with a very, very happy group.
I can't hear you. Okay, Jack, congratulations. Two in a row. Tell me the difference between this one and the first one.
They're both so sweet in different ways. I mean, this one wasn't as dramatic, obviously, but it was just as satisfying. I mean, at halftime, this game was in doubt, and we absolutely came out and played clinic basketball in the second half, and that's against a good basketball team.
What was the message at halftime? How did you get your team's attention to play such good basketball, as you indicated?
Well, I thought we had a big shot made right before half by Steve Hicklin. You know, Nick was saddled with foul trouble, hadn't scored. I just felt we were in good shape if we would just really get back to pointer basketball, making plays for one another. And we sure did at both ends of the floor.
Congratulations. The Bennett family is synonymous with basketball. Great win, Coach. Let me talk to a couple of your stars here.
Thank you, Eddie.
Nick, scoreless in the first half. What was your mindset coming out in the second half?
Same mindset as I had in the first half. They did an excellent job guarding me. I got in a little foul trouble. I had to sit on the bench a little longer than I'd like. But luckily, my teammates, not one of them doubted me. They all believed in me. They all said, when you get the ball, shoot it. we've just had the same mindset our whole season. This is our goal, to get back here and hopefully get back and win it again. And I just couldn't be happier right now.
Jason, I interviewed you last year. You made the winning shot. You were the only player from Illinois with all these bunch of Wisconsin guys. You brought your brother on board. How's it feel to have another guy from Illinois at Wisconsin Stevens Point?
It's real special, you know. We knew all about the program. We knew we had a chance to come here and be champions, and that's what we've done 2 years in a row. It's the best feeling in the world.
Where did you develop your talent? Did you grow late? Your skills are terrific at 6'7". Tell me about your development as a basketball player.
You know, I think it's just been every year. You know, every day I try to get better. I think our whole team does that, and it's just been a great ride.
Congratulations, guys, on a great win. Two championships in a row for the Pointers. Have a great trip back to Wisconsin. And back to Joe. Take it back to Joe.
Gentlemen, much appreciated. Here in Salem, Wisconsin Stevens Point doing some damage again. Back-to-back national champions. Jack Bennett, Tamaris Relaford, his injured point guard. All smiles. We're back to wrap in just a few moments.
I believe I actually saw a Fighting Irish game in South Bend. Amazing. The energy, the tradition, you can see why it's such a football shrine. Wish you were here.
Introducing the One College Sports Show to watch if you're only watching one. A fast-moving power hour packed with all things college. The One College Sports Show, this season on College Sports TV. Find out more at collegesports.com.
Wisconsin Stevens Point, today with win number 29, equaling a single season mark. They are back-to-back Division III national champions, besting Rochester by the final of 73-49. Our Sirius satellite radio player of the game, Coach Fogler, it's Nick Bennett who got real hot in the second half.
Well, he sure did, Joe. A young man who's tough-minded, a young man, a coach's son, has been around the game a long time, knew he would come out and play better and score points for the Pointers.
This senior class was so special for Wisconsin Stevens Point. So much of their offense relied upon those guys. And Eddie, in the final analysis, when you look at Wisconsin Stevens Point, they were a team that was just utterly dominant.
Well, they were. The inside presence was way too much. A very big team, but an excellent passing team, a very smart basketball team. And I think the experience, Joe, last year of winning at one time was a great benefit and an advantage for them here today as well.
You could just see the emotion written all over the players' faces, the jubilation in the stands. Wisconsin Stevens Point, the players now being honored with the national championship trophy and the individual awards. Jack Bennett's 200th win as a career coach. As we eavesdrop to the radio call, the final call of the countdown for Stevens Point.
You know what? That makes the championship all the more better.
Tyler Doyle, left side to Boucher, 15 seconds to go on the shot clock and one extra on the game clock right now. Brett Hirsch with it. Over it'll come to Brad Kelso. 4 seconds to go. Kelso, he's going to launch the jumper. Didn't get anything, and that clock will run out. Your final score, Stevens Point is the national champion. As they win it here, 73-49 over Rochester University.
Scott Krieger, the lead voice there, the kaboom for sure. The offensive whammy pounded down by Wisconsin Stevens Point, a victor today in the Division III national championship game. For head coach Eddie Fogler and for our entire CSTV crew, Joe Beninati thanking you for your time from Salem. For more, log on to CSTV.com, the ultimate destination for scores, news, highlights, and analysis. This has been a presentation of CSTV, college sports television, number one in college sports. It has been a wonderful national weekend in the semifinals and finals. Wisconsin, Stevens Point, just too much for Rochester as we send you to the Fieldhouse in New York for the One College Sports Show.